Hello, welcome to the Netherlands and welcome to this program. I'd like to explain in this episode the workings of a Wadley loop receiver and especially the Racal 17L, but in fact all the Wadley loop receivers. Here you see the only Racal 17LD machine in existence. There's only one example in the world and it's standing right here. And it was built from a scrap machine. The machine was very badly damaged. But the filters, those very special filters, were intact. And we used those filters again, but then with semiconductors, mostly FETs. As you can see, there's a digital readout, but that's the only thing that's digital about the machine. The machine is like an original 17L, fully analogue, but as stable as you can imagine. This story of the genius South African Trevor Lloyd Wadley starts in World War II. Finding enemy aircraft and warning HQ was nothing better than a joke. Sound finding with prehistoric amplifiers. So he worked in all secrecy for the Allied on the development of radar. John Randall and Harry Booth developed the first cavity magnetron, but a lot of work must still be done before radar becomes operational. In that period, Wadley also developed a way of stabilizing the receiving frequency for a shortwave radio. Quite a problem in those days, unless you want to use a lot of crystals. But something else seems more important. With the development of his tellurometer, Wadley became world famous. Finally, after developing an equipment for measurements on the ionosphere, he became time and money to experiment with his frequency stabilization. The prototype worked very well and he decided to give an order of 6 pieces in the radio factory of SMD. In 1953, the new company Racal needed desperately a brilliant new design to compete with the Collins R388. They asked Mr. Wadley to help out, and together with the Racal engineers, he developed the famous Type 17. Drift of the oscillators was in those days a fact of life. There was obviously a solution using crystals, but if you want to make a receiver that is quite easily tunable between say 500 kHz and 30 MHz, you need a lot of crystals. A Wadley loop receiver is very fast tunable between the highest and the lowest frequency. How that works, we will show you. We'll be right back. In this first block you see pre-selection. The pre-selection consists of an aerial attenuator, very needed because the receiver is very, very sensitive. A band switch from 500 kHz to 30 MHz and a tuning knob. Signal, that aerial signal, is going into the first mixer. And very standard, there is a free-running oscillator from 40 to 70 MHz that is mixed with the incoming signal. Making the first IF of around 40 MHz. The bandwidth of that EF amplifier is 1.2 MHz. Down here we see a crystal oscillator. The signal from that oscillator is disformed and thus producing even and uneven harmonics. So on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are harmonics. All of those harmonics are fed into a low pass filter with a cutoff on 32 MHz. So from 1 to 30 MHz there is an harmonic available. So all harmonics from 1 MHz is fed into that extra mixer. And the other side of the mixer gets the original VFO signal. So together they are producing an enormous amount of signals. But only the 37 MHz is filtered out. Filtered out in a very special filter. So let's look inside. Here you can see the separate coils. The coils are not coupled, only by air. And the distance between the coils is making it so that the bandwidth of this filter, 8 in total, is extremely narrow. The quality is very high. The unwanted frequencies are suppressed by more than 80 dB. The output of that filter is going into mixer 2. And it's mixed with the first IF that's on 40 MHz. So what's the trick here? Well, it's really very simple. Suppose the VFO is drifting upwards. The same signal that is used to mix with the aerial signals is also fed into that extra mixer. So the 37 MHz component will have also that drift. And it's fed into mixer 2 to compensate for the first drift. How? Well, very easily. The VFO is above the receiving frequency and the 37 MHz signal is below the 40 MHz IF. So they compensate fully. The 3 MHz signal is fed into a second pre-selection, and that pre-selection is tuning like an ordinary heterodyne receiver. The second VFO is free running, but very, very stable, and then producing the last IF on 100 kilocycles. From there, the signal is going to demodulation and automatic gain control. We'll be right back. Every Wadley receiver you can very easily recognize, because all the receivers have a separate tuning for the megahertz and a separate tuning for the kilohertz.